Welcome to the fifth segment of our nutrition tools section, and this section is going to cover the nutrition facts label. What I want to do is start out with our current nutrition facts label, and I'll go over this in more detail, but point out some of the differences with the new nutrition facts label, which should be rolling out sometime this year, maybe next year, but this is going to be the new plans. And a couple of the features that we'll see in the new label is a very bold, large serving sizes per container. And I think this is very important, especially for those sugary drinks that come in a bottle this big, and you might think you're just having one serving when really there are 2.5 or 3 servings. So those tell you in big, bold letters how many servings per container. The calories is going to be very large and in bold. The daily values, and I'll go over this in a minute, it's going to be on the other side. This is all this information here about your macronutrients and then some of your micronutrients like sodium are larger. And then one very important key, which I'm really excited about, is added sugars are listed. Manufacturers definitely fought this. They don't want to tell you how many sugars they added to the product. So this will be fantastic once we have the new label. And then in larger, we'll look at some of our important nutrients, and I like that they included potassium instead of vitamin A. So before we had vitamin A on there, now we're going to have potassium. So what we'll do now is go to the current nutrition facts label and just go over how to navigate through the nutrition facts label. What I'm going to be doing is going to the Mayo Clinic Interactive Nutrition Facts label. So this is the nutrition facts label, and you can see the top, it shows you how many serving sizes. And this is generally in standard measurements, and it'll tell you how many serving sizes per container. Next, you'll see the calories, and then the number of calories from fat. Next, you'll see the total fat, saturated fat, trans fat, cholesterol, sodium, sugars. These are generally nutrients that you want to limit. That's shown here in orange. So this is how many of those grams per serving. In green, what you'll find is nutrients, vitamin A, calcium, C, and iron, as well as fiber. These are nutrients you want to increase. Now this is the percent daily value, and this shows how much of a specific nutrient one serving of the product has in comparison to how much you need in a day. Now this is for a standard 2,000 calorie diet. You might need 1,500 calories, or maybe you need 3,000. So this might not be the best value for you, but it allows you to compare products. That's what the percent daily values are best for, but also to get a general idea. If we look at total fat at 6 grams, 6 grams might not register anything, but if you say, well, this is 9% of the daily value, that means if you eat one serving, you're going to get 9% of what you need for the entire day. And that's important. If you look down at sodium, you say, okay, if I ate just one serving of this product, I would get 11%. But maybe you ate 3 servings or 5 servings. That's very possible considering the type of food that you're eating. Then 5 times 11, we're getting up over 50% of our needs for the day. And that's where the percent daily values are very helpful to give you an idea of what you might be getting for your entire day's needs from eating one serving or to compare products. You also notice the values for vitamin A, calcium, vitamin C, and iron. Lastly, let's take a look at our percent daily values based on a 2,000 calorie diet. You can see that both 2,000 calories and 2,500 are listed. Generally, I like to go with the 2,000 calorie recommendation because some people need less, some people need more. But it tells you how many of each of these nutrients you need. So total fat should be about 65 grams for the day. That's what you need for the day. Saturated fat, 25 grams. You don't want to go above that. Cholesterol, sodium, carbohydrate, and fiber. So this is the same on every single label. You will always find this at the bottom of every label, usually for 2,000 calories, sometimes 2,500 calories is listed.